UWC Heavyweight Championship.
I heard any of your guys in the main event.
Don't talk. I thought we won tonight. That's all that matters.
You didn't win tonight. You lost.
The last thing I remember, we were winning.
You found out, you saw what you get when you mess with the orphan. You saw what you get when you mess with the orphan.
Stop stealing my lines.
There's the Thriller, Andy Bivians. Biggest match of his young career. Debuted here in UWC a little more than 5 years ago, has never wrestled for the heavyweight championship before, former three-time tag team champion.
Excuse you, sir. Andy Bivians.
Actually, four-time tag team champion.
He just broke our hearts, and he's still dancing. We don't care, he's listening. You missed the whole session. Oh, my heart is broken. My heart is broken.
There he is, the heavyweight champion of the world, Textbook Philly Madison. He's held that title since February. Just shy of 10 months. That's a very long reign. One of the longer reigns in UWC history.
Yeah, it's been a long reign, but he didn't defend it last month. Just sat up in a chair and just watched.
And I gotta tell you, when he saw Andy Bivians win, he was not happy about that. I don't think he wants to face him on your mind.
Very possible he doesn't. These men are both fan favorites.
Well, these guys have battled in tag matches many times in the past.
Absolutely. They've wrestled for the tag team titles, in fact.
But this is the first time they've ever met one-on-one.
And this is for the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
For all the proverbial marbles.
This matchup is for one fall with a 60-minute time limit. Introducing first, weighing in at 190 pounds, from the Kingdom of Glass, he is the King of Glass, Andy Bivians.
I'm going to take a break while Daisy introduces Philly Madison, because this is going to take a while.
Okay. I'll send you a flare when it's over.
Hailing from Manhattan, New York, weighing in at 199 pounds, he is one of UWC's elite Triple Crown champions, a former UWC United States champion, a former two-time UWC tag team champion, with the longest reign of 1,092 days. He is currently the lightest UWC heavyweight champion in the 19-plus year history of the UWC. He is a pinballer, shockola, wrestling brawler, the 16-bit superstar, the resurrector of retro, the puppet master of professional wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, Textbook Philly Madison.
She is now.
Thank God, I had time to put it in order, get my meal, and I just about finished it.
Chicken fingers?
No, Joe rules it. Wrightstown, New Jersey. A shirt is very, very expensive here.
And we're set to go. This should be a scientific encounter between two fan favorites, two men who have a lot of respect for each other.
Like I said, I don't necessarily know if that's the case.
Hey, Philly Madison just knew that Bivians would be a tough opponent and didn't want to wrestle him for that reason. I don't think there's anything personal against Andy Bivians.
Maybe he fears Andy Bivians.
And there's a handshake.
Man, I don't believe in that. That's garbage. Who wants to see that kind of stuff?
Gabe Sapolsky.
Yeah, you want to see Gabe Sapolsky shake your hand.
No, I don't. Nor do I want to see Barry Silk get anywhere near my hand.
You're a fan of what he's doing.
Bivians with the early takeover here.
Madison looking very focused here.
He wants to hold on. This is the biggest match of his career. Madison's been the UWC for 14 years.
He defended the heavyweight championship against the Ripper. That was the biggest match of his career.
This is the first time he's ever headlined UWC's premier event of the year, Toys for Tots.
Yeah, but he's headlined New Lisbon at least 100. But that's just because he lives there.
Those shows aren't canon. I keep telling you that.
We got a scoop. Walking him around the ring.
Scooping a slam. Maybe taking a little bit too much time to preen for the crowd. I think he needs to follow up here. This is a heavyweight championship.
Oh, look at that. A little curtsy there.
This is a heavyweight title. You've got to be aggressive. Like, especially against a great champion like Madison, who's held the title for about 9 months.
It's all about attitude. He's trying to show. Bivians is trying to show this a little more out there sort of personality, trying to make it as a single
They lost the tag team title match to Slayer and Rudo the heel, and then they decided respectfully to go their own ways, try to make their way in the singles round.
Now apparently Andy Bivians wants to give everybody here for Christmas a party rock. Ducks the clothesline.
Wait, he's going for that backslide. This is how Kerry Von Erich won the heavyweight championship. Only gets a count of two.
I'll say this. This place does a little bit remind me of Dallas.
Not enough. They don't love Jesus as much here.
Jesus would never come. Now Madison with the backslide.
Two. Only gets a count of two. Both men miss a drop kick. Square off. Shake hands. They're still very respectful in the early going.
I don't buy this. Look at Madison now clapping around. I don't buy this from Philly Madison for a second. Philly Madison is a devious, evil person.
He turned over a new leaf just about 2 years ago, but he helped bring your man, Mighty Moe, down. Boston that U.S. championship.
He got involved with Mighty Foe, okay?
Big suplex coming right here. Only gets a count of one.
Wants the referee to count a little bit faster. After he's going to the top.
Going to the top rope this early in the match, this is a big gamble right here.
He's taking his time to get out there, too.
But Madison's already back to his feet.
Oh, he better be careful. Oh! Right into the stage. Chin first.
Which you would have seen if I was on the ball there. I apologize.
Unfortunately, you're on your own ball.
Be that as it may,
Juan Farina is getting involved here.
Madison thinks he's very smart for that one. Yes, that was a clever move. But perhaps of a little bit of a more of a shade of gray in the morality department.
Billy Madison now. I thought he wanted the count out, but now he's going to the outside. He could be going for that running knee. And he hits him with it.
Drives the knee right to the side of the head.
He hit me with that one. Didn't feel good. Well, he hit somebody else and they ran into me. Either way, it didn't feel good.
Domino effect.
Domino was not in the match.
So it wasn't total domination?
It wasn't global domination, no. Now, Madison could be going for that Russian leg sweep.
There it is. Goes to the cover. One, two, only counts two. comes off the ropes. Misses the elbow. Both men down.
Challenger trying to get the fans behind him. Now it's Philly Madison trying to get the crowd behind him.
I think the crowd's a little bit more behind Bivians than they are behind Madison.
Oh, great clothesline.
It's always hard being the champion, because the crowd always wants to see a title change. The crowd turns on you very quickly.
You're setting them up.
Scoop and slam. It's the Little John elbow drop. Two. Yeah.
You sound like a complete idiot.
Fair.
I'll be setting up for that big five arm.
It's the STO. That's it. That is it. Two, three, no.
What? He kicked out of Philly Madison's STO. That's his finisher. He's beaten a ton of guys like that with that move.
I've never seen anybody kick out of that. That's incredible.
He was taught that move by the great Kobe Carino.
UWC legend.
Now Bivian
setting him up. Over the cover. Two.
Does he have him?
Oh, I thought he had him.
I think he might have. That was a slow count by the referee.
The count was even. The count is always the same. It's always is a consistent count and it's a fair count. It can be slow, it can be fast, and it needs to be consistent.
Now Bivian, I figure at this point, his first singles, big singles title match, I figured he would be questioning if he's got what it takes, but he's going forward and he's going to the top rope again.
He's as confident as ever here.
Last time he thought of going to the top rope, he got cut off by Madison. And Philly this time, he catches him again.
History repeats itself, he's going for that superplex.
Saves a Barry Windham.
Pushes him off.
Catches him.
Big press slam.
Off the top rope. And what's Philly Madison doing now?
He's going up to the top rope now. This could be it. This could be all.
Is he going for that big splash? Oh, knee drop.
He missed it.
I think he hurt his knee.
I think he did hurt his knee.
He came down on that left knee hard. Or that right knee, rather.
Oh, he gets the count of two.
Bivians kicks out, but I think Philly Madison's got a lot more to worry about here. He made the cover, but he's hurt.
He may have blown out his knee right here.
He might have tore his ACL, his MCL. I can't tell from here.
Lateral collateral ligaments might be damaged severely.
At least Bruce has missed it. I don't know. Referee George is telling Forearm Farina and Commissioner Joe Rules that Philly Madison might not be able to continue. Bivians is going to get ready to hit him with a big move.
But no, Tanah is cutting him off because of Madison's injury. We've already seen Joe Rules' forearm Farina carry one man out of the ring tonight. We might be seeing him carry a second man out.
Bivians doesn't even know what happened. Remember, he was out when he got hit with the knee. So he hasn't seen. He doesn't exactly know how bad Philly Madison's hurt here.
He may have injured his knee on the Bivians' head.
No, I think he hurt it when he hit the mat.
He may have dislocated his kneecap. This could be surgery. This could put Madison out of action. 6 to 9 months.
All right, now it's Madison from behind. It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Philly Madison is okay.
Madison retains the title. But I don't know.
It's a Christmas miracle, Wilcox. It's a Christmas miracle.
I don't think his knee was damaged in the first place.
What are you talking about?
Of
course it was hurt.
I think he did that to try to lure in Andy Bivian.
The referee clearly saw that Philly Madison was hurt.
He just jumped right on that knee. There's nothing wrong with him.
And thanks to Santa Claus, he came here and gave Philly Madison his wish to retain the UWC Heavyweight title. Now he's dancing a little. Thank you, Santa Claus, for helping Philly Madison.
He might have been right. He might have been back to his own ways.
Whoa, wait a minute.
No respect here.
Whoa, wait a minute. Bivians and Philly Madison are going at it. This match is over.
Joe Rules and the United Force are hitting the ring to try to break it up. Here comes Nate Mustang.
And 4-3 to all coming in.
Oh no, 4-3 is in there. Everybody's going to scatter now.
4-3 to finally got Andy Bivians to the back. No, Bivians is still going at Philly Madison.
No rules.
What a poor sportsman that Andy Bivians is.
What
the terrible sportsmanship Andy Bivians is showing. Philly Madison had a miraculous comeback. We sat here, we thought he was going to be out 8 months. We thought he'd be coming back at the same time as Tyler Black, but apparently not. My brother, by the way. And now they're still going at it.
That's going to be a situation worth keeping an eye on. There wasn't any bad blood going into this match. Now there is.
Well, I think Philly Madison's probably going to have to go get that knee checked out at the hospital.
He's fine. Would you be serious?
It's a Christmas miracle.
You're still your heavyweight champion, Textbook Philly Madison.